Hi, my name is Noah Gift, and today we're going to cover how to test .NET code inside of the GitHub Actions ecosystem alongside GitHub Codespaces. What's really cool about this is I can click a button, create a repo, create a development environment that uses Visual Studio Code in the cloud, go through, test my code, and then automatically get this to run with GitHub Actions. All right, let's go ahead and get started. All right, so we're gonna get in here and build out a C# XUnit GitHub Actions continuous integration environment. We're also gonna do it inside of GitHub Codespaces, which is a cloud-based development environment. So to go ahead and get started here, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna create a new environment. And in this new environment here, what'll be nice is that I'll be able to start from zero. So go ahead and do this. We'll go ahead and say demo, C# GitHub Codespaces. And what I'll be able to do here is say public, add a README. What we'll do VS Visual Studio here as our template. Perfect. And go ahead and create this repo. Once I've created it, we're able to go to code, and I'm going to select Codespace, and I'm going to go to this icon right here, and I'm going to select configure and create Codespace. Once I've done this, I'll be able to select whatever size machine I want. Because I'm compiling code, I want a beefy machine. I'm going to go ahead and select 16 core with 32 gigs of RAM and 128 gigs of storage. Great. Let's go ahead and create this Codespace. Now that I've got this thing, what's really cool about it is I can use Visual Studio Code, the desktop type environment, but inside of the cloud. I'll go ahead and go through here and configure the color theme. I like to use the color theme here for Visual Studio Dark. Perfect. Got this thing working. Now that I've got this, we're really ready to start installing things. And so the next step for me is I'm going to copy what I did earlier here, which is I'm going to make a directory and I'm going to cd into it. Then I'm going to run .NET new XUnit. So let's go ahead and first actually check the .NET version. So if we say .NET --version, what do we got? We are running .NET 6, which is what I want. That's great. Let's go ahead and now make a directory for our tests, hello tests, cd into it, and then use the .NET command to create a new XUnit command here. Looks like we have too many steps here, which is fine. I'll just go ahead and cd into hello tests, and now I'll go ahead and run .NET new XUnit. Perfect. So this goes through here and it creates our template for .NET. And it gives me this directory right here with a starter kit for our code. Because I'm going to do this as a demo, I want to move quickly. And what I can do is I can actually just grab my example from what I did earlier. And I'm going to go ahead and just paste it in here. And this is a very simple example. What it does is it not only builds out a test, and you can see here, this is the way the test work. Fact is at the top of the public void passing test. And I say assert equal 2 and 2. And then inside, I actually build the logic. This is not obviously not something you would do in a real world scenario, but I'm just going to add a method here that is able to add two integers together and return them. And then I'm going to assert that that's actually true. And so once I've got this set up here, we're pretty close. All we need to do is actually run our code. And how would I actually do that? Well, fortunately, in my other project here, I actually set up GitHub Actions, and we'll do this in a second. And what's nice about GitHub Actions is that you can actually use it as really like a template to understand how to run your project. So here we go, .NET test, hello test, no build, verbosity normal. Let's go ahead and run this. Uh-oh, it says what's happening here. Because I'm in this directory, I can just go up one level, and now I can run that command. And you can see here that, in fact, it is a build failure because I believe we need to first create the DLL. And so in order to do that, pretty easy, we would just go through here and we would just say the build command. And so we can, again, just follow our steps here. We can say .NET restore hello tests. Let's go ahead and do that. That goes through and it checks to see if there's any dependencies and installs them. And then we go ahead and we build our project, our next step. Perfect. That's going to go ahead and create that DLL. Once that's done, now we can run our test command. So this is really cool, is that once you start to build out a continuous integration workflow, it actually should match identically. In this case, it does match. We see that there's a passed test right here. So we got the testing working locally here. Now the trick is, how do we make the build system, which is GitHub Actions, do it automatically? And so I'm going to go ahead and show you how to do that. So I'm going to say git status, and we see here's our directory full of our code. Let's go ahead and add that. It's nice that I don't have to do much because I have GitHub integrated with SSH keys and all that stuff already automatically, because it's GitHub Codespaces adding test project. I go ahead and push this. And now that I've got this pushed, if I refresh, you'll see that I've got all this inside of here. To use GitHub Actions, I can go ahead and select this icon, GitHub Actions, and notice it'll even give me suggestions like, here we go, build and test a .NET app, et cetera, et cetera. What we can do, and I do think it's a good idea to explore those, but we can just select create a workspace for ourselves. And I'm going to go to my other project here where I had already done a lot of the hard work, and I'm going to paste this inside of this project. There we go. Now let's go ahead and read what it says. We call this thing .NET, and what it's going to do is it's going to, on every push, and in fact, let's just leave this. We just care about pushes. Let's go ahead and build the main branch. It's going to run in Ubuntu, right? So Linux is going to actually test our C# code. We're going to make sure that it's using .NET 6, and then we're going to run three commands. First, we're going to restore the dependencies, .NET restore hello test. We did that earlier. Second, we're going to build. So .NET build hello test, no restore. And then we're going to go through and run test. And this will say .NET test hello test, no build. Let's go ahead and commit this. And once it's committed, if we go back here and we look at this, it'll take a second here to run. Let's go ahead and double check. Here we go. It's running. We can actually watch the build in action. And this is what's really nice about this continuous integration environment, is I can toggle it and in real time make sure that everything works. If I'm working with a bunch of developers, we can ensure that all of our code is actually able to run. Here we go. Here's step two, restoring the dependencies. Building comes next. Once that's done, the testing goes next. And of course, things are able to pass. Perfect. And now if I want to, I can add this status badge. I can go to this menu here, click status badge, copy it, then go back to the README and paste it in. So as you can see, very, very straightforward to set up continuous integration inside of GitHub Codespaces for C#. And in fact, I can just go back here, do a git pull. It pulls everything in. I can run those same commands again. .NET test, we see everything works. So a very great environment for doing continuous integration with C# is this GitHub plus GitHub Codespaces plus GitHub Actions workflow.